Want to speak real Thai from your first lesson? Sign up for your free lifetime account at ThaiPod101.com.
Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Thai Top Words. I'm Jay, and today's lesson is 10 most romantic ideas for a date. Let's begin. Dinner Thai Sang Tian. Candlelit dinner. Dinner Thai Sang Tian. Candlelit dinner. He brought me to a candlelit dinner. You guys might have noticed that we use the word dinner instead of ahan yen because we want it to be more fancy or more fashionable in this way. Bai len bowling, to go bowling. Bai len bowling, to go bowling. Kun yak bai len bowling gap chan mai? Do you want to go bowling with me? Personally, I don't like to go bowling because I'm not good at it. But if you are interested, then most of the bowling centers are located on top of the of our shopping mall in Thailand. So it's quite easy to find. Pai pipitthapan sat nam, to go to the aquarium. Pai pipitthapan sat nam, to go to the aquarium. Chan yak pai pipitthapan sat nam. I want to go to the aquarium. In English, you have like one word for this. It is aquarium, right? But in Thai language, the word pipitthapan actually means museum, and satnam means sea creature or sea animal. So together, it's an aquarium. Pai rong lakon opera, to go to the opera. Pai rong lakon opera, to go to the opera. Prung ni chan jia pai rong lakon opera. Tomorrow, I'll go to the opera. Strangely, in Thailand, I don't think we have an opera house or an opera show. Maybe there is, but I have never heard of it. Bai suan sat, to go to the zoo. Bai suan sat, to go to the zoo. Kun yak bai suan sat mai? Do you want to go to the zoo? Do you? Bai picnic, to have a picnic. วันนี้อากาศดีไปปิกนิกกันไหม? It's nice weather today. Let's have a picnic. If you want to have a picnic in Thailand, then I recommend you to go to Snam Luang in Bangkok. Very nice, like it's a huge field yard that you can walk along or just sit there. However, because of our weather, it's a bit hot, so be prepared.
ทานมื้อเย็นและดูภาพยนตร์
to have dinner and see a movie.
ทานมื้อเย็นและดูภาพยนตร์
to have dinner and see a movie. My favorite activity.
เขาชอบพาฉันไปทานมื้อเย็นและดูภาพยนตร์
He likes to take me to have dinner and see a movie. In this sentence, if you notice, there are two phrases. ทานมื้อเย็น is to have dinner and ดูภาพยนตร์ is to see a movie. But the word ภาพยนตร์ is actually a bit formal. So in daily life, you say "du nang" instead of "du papayon" for seeing a movie.
Nang rua ferry, to take a ferry ride. Nang rua ferry, to take a ferry ride. Bai nang rua ferry gan mai? Shall we take a ferry ride?
Yeah, I remember there are a lot of foreigners who like to take a ferry ride in Bangkok. You know, we have a big river called Chao Phraya River, crossing the whole city. So if you are interested, try to search, and I think it is a good experience.
เดินเล่นริมชายหาด, to walk on the beach. เดินเล่นริมชายหาด, to walk on the beach. เย็นนี้ไปเดินเล่นริมชายหาดกันไหม?
Shall we go for a walk on the beach this evening?
ไปพิพิธภัณฑ์, to go to the museum. ไปพิพิธภัณฑ์, to go to the museum. เธออยากไปพิพิธภัณฑ์กับฉันไหม?
Do you want to go to the museum with me? If you have a chance to visit Bangkok, I want to recommend you to this place called Museum Siam. Museum Siam is actually a name of this museum which collects all the information about Bangkok and Thailand in general. Oh, we are done. Okay, we are done for today. To think of it, I think Thai people usually watch a movie on a date. How about you guys? What do you do on your date? Don't forget to like the video, subscribe to our channel, and visit our website at thaipod101.com. See you next time. Bye bye.
Maybe first you can pretend like you know the person from somewhere, okay? That always works.
Nice to meet you.
Hey. Wait, that's English.
Yeah.
Hola, Maca. Me han dicho que dius Anja. ¿Es correcta?
Very sexy inside.
Mexican?
No,
Mexican sounds
good. Is it Spanish?
No.
No.
Va, que llegiré una frase. D'accord?
Yes.
Portuguese?
No.
So maybe it's Spain. Spanish, like.
It's in Spain.
How do they say it? Maybe I don't know how to say it in English. Catalonese?
Yeah.
Really?
Catalan.
Oh, really?
Hola. ¿Cómo estás? Hola, Max. ¿Cómo estás? La verdad es que te iba a tirar un chamuyo barato, pero te vi los ojos y no sé, te quiero invitar a salir, te quiero para algo serio. La verdad que no soy de hacer estas cosas, es raro en mí, pero desde el momento en el que te vi, estoy sintiendo cosas que antes no sentía. No sé qué me está pasando y no sé si es tu voz o tu sonrisa, pero me parece que tenemos que ir a tomar algo juntos, así que lo que voy a hacer es darte mi número de teléfono, me vas a escribir, tal vez nos vamos a enamorar, no sé, veremos qué pasa. ¿Está bien?
No sé.
I know.
Wow, this is like love confession.
I have to admit that it was like kind of romantic, like the pronunciation and stuff.
Yeah.
But like, yeah, the content is a bit cheesy. Yeah. Ah, sorry about that.
Is it Spanish language, right?
I don't know. You think so?
Yeah.
Es castellano, exactamente.
我喜欢跟你在一起的感觉。我能请你喝杯东西吗？你怎么那么可爱？
It was so sudden. I don't want.
This is easy.
Are you willing to come to my place afterwards? Yeah, just like to be kind of like spice things up a bit.
Like it's Mandarin.
Yes. How come you know?
I've got a lot of Chinese friends.
Aww.
라면 먹고 갈래?
Okay.
Yeah. This is obvious for me.
It means, do you want to drop by my house and eat instant noodle with me?
This sounds like something like Chinese or Vietnamese to me.
Do you really use it? I mean, well, or it's just like...
This line is from a movie, actually everyone knows. Yeah, ta.
That's it.
Yeah, ta.
Korean, right?
Okay, so let's say... Korean.
But please remember this line. Okay. 라면 먹고 갈래?
라면 먹고 갈래?
This line is usually used by female.
Oh.
So it's like, I will
try. Today I will try.
Yeah. 라면 먹고 갈래?
라면 먹고 갈래?
Yeah.
どこかでお会いしたことありますか?
ないと思います。
今度一緒にご飯でもどうですか?
まだ食べた。
まだ食べた。It means no, maybe. I didn't expect the answer.
It was like one way. Japanese.
僕が必ず君を守るから。
Oh, I got excited.
And now I get really shy because she understands.
I understand you.
It means like I'm going to protect you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like, you know, they don't say in real world.
Yeah. But sometimes you see drama. In drama. Yeah, drama. But it's too romantic,
yeah.
I think.
I want to give a message from here to the world. Mm-hmm. Don't watch so much drama. Come and experience real life first, right?
That's true.
Du är så vacker. Så det ger solen en anledning att skina.
Wow.
Wow. This one is hard.
You're so beautiful. Mm-hmm. You give the sun a reason to shine.
Wow.
It doesn't look like something European or... I feel like it might be indie.
Oh, yeah, this is a good one. Dina läppar smakar som vin och ikväll vill jag bli berusad.
Okay, like it looks so different to me right now. Like I feel like it's something European right now and like something Germanic, but not German.
Hint.
What's the letter it starts with?
The letter it starts with?
Yeah.
S.
Can you say it again? This one?
Yeah, yeah.
Not because I like the compliment.
Yeah. I'll say it as many times as you like. Om det hade varit kriminellt att vara snygg, hade du fått livstid.
Okay, this is like something European because I hear no criminal.
Du är så, you said, right?
Du är så.
Du är så. Is it a European language?
Yes.
Swedish?
Holy cow.
Swedish, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I know, because I have friends from Sweden.
Ah.
Hello again.
Oh, you're a beautiful girl.
You are a girl.
What? I thought it was a girl.
What, really? Hello.
Oh, hello.
Hey.
Difficult.
Usually I've got some bad stereotypes about like Spanish, but the Spanish one was quite good, I think. But that's not the winner. To me, like, okay. I think it was Korean, mainly because I couldn't understand like what it meant.
I don't know. I just think Spanish sounds maybe the most sexiest of the languages I've heard today. Yeah, I didn't know much of Catalan, the sound of that, and that was really nice as well. Now, since my husband is Korean, Korean was attractive, I think, because that's why maybe I fell in love with him, right? But also, it's really hard to decide because Castellano and also the Canton language, it sounds also very attractive. I don't know, maybe it's because of their tonation. I don't know why, but even though I don't know the meaning, it sounds like very natural, very confident, so I like that language too.
ดีค่ะเจค่ะวิดีโอนี้เราจะมาพูดคุยเกี่ยวกับวันวาเลนไทน์หรือที่หลายคนเรียกว่าวันแห่งความรักซึ่งตรงกับวันที่14กุมภาพันธ์ของทุกปีแม้จะไม่ใช่วันสำคัญที่มีต้นกำเนิดมาจากประเทศไทยโดยตรงแต่คนไทยก็ให้ความสำคัญกับวันนี้เป็นอย่างมากเช่นกันเพราะเป็นวันที่แสดงความรักที่มีต่อกันไม่ว่าจะเป็นคู่รักเพื่อนหรือครอบครัวเริ่มสนใจกันแล้วใช่ไหมคะถ้าพร้อมแล้วไปฟังกันเลยค่ะก่อนแต่งงานตามธรรมเนียมในประเทศไทยเจ้าบ่าวจะต้องให้บางอย่างแก่ครอบครัวเจ้าสาวสิ่งนั้นคืออะไรเราจะเฉลยคำตอบในช่วงท้ายของวิดีโอนี้ค่ะเนื่องจากวันวาเลนไทน์ไม่ถือเป็นวันหยุดราชการบรรดาคู่รักจึงใช้เวลาในตอนเย็นชวนกันออกไปกินข้าวตามร้านอาหารต่างๆส่วนใหญ่จะไปตามห้างสรรพสินค้าเพราะจะมีกิจกรรมมากมายให้คู่รักทำร่วมกันอีกทั้งยังมีมุมสวยๆให้ถ่ายภาพเป็นที่ระลึกมากมายหลังจากนั้นก็อาจปิดท้ายด้วยการดูหนังรอบดึกบางคนก็จะพาครอบครัวออกมากินข้าวข้างนอกบ้านบ้างถือเป็นการแสดงความรักอีกรูปแบบหนึ่งถ้าพูดถึงวันวาเลนไทน์สิ่งที่ขาดไม่ได้เลยสำหรับคู่รักนั่นก็คือของขวัญที่ประเทศไทยส่วนใหญ่ผู้ชายจะเป็นฝ่ายให้ผู้หญิงโดยส่วนใหญ่จะให้ดอกกุหลาบหรือช็อกโกแลตซึ่งแสดงถึงความรักได้ดีมักจะให้คู่กับการ์ดเพื่อสื่อความในใจ คนที่อยากสารภาพรักก็มักจะบอกผู้หญิงผ่านการให้ของขวัญเช่นกันถ้าเป็นเพื่อนก็มักจะให้ของขวัญเล็กๆน้อยๆต่อกันเช่นกุหลาบคนละดอกหรือช็อกโกแลตเล็กๆคนละชิ้นคู่รักชาวไทยจำนวนมากเลือกวันวาเลนไทน์เป็นวันแต่งงานและจดทะเบียนสมรสโดยในตอนเช้าของทุกๆปีหน้าอำเภอบางรักจะมีคู่รักมากกว่า 1,000 คู่มารอคิวเพื่อจดทะเบียนสมรสเพราะชื่ออำเภอมีความหมายว่าอำเภอแห่งความรักอีกหนึ่งงานแต่งงานที่สามารถทำได้เฉพาะวันนี้เท่านั้นก็คืองานแต่งงานใต้น้ำซึ่งถูกจัดขึ้นที่ทะเลในจังหวัดตรังทุกปีจะมีคู่รักทั้งชาวไทยและชาวต่างชาติให้ความสนใจจนถูกบันทึกให้เป็นงานแต่งงานใต้น้ำที่มีผู้เข้าร่วมมากที่สุดในโลกในประเทศไทยเวลาผู้ชายซื้อช่อดอกกุหลาบให้คนรักความสำคัญไม่ได้อยู่ที่ขนาดของช่อแต่อยู่ที่จำนวนดอกกุหลาบในช่อเพราะจำนวนของดอกกุหลาบมีความหมายซ่อนอยู่เช่น9ดอกหมายถึงเราสองคนจะรักกันตลอดไป20ดอกหมายถึงฉันมีความจริงใจต่อเธอเป็นต้นและตอนนี้เราจะเฉลยคำตอบของคำถามในช่วงต้นของวิดีโอกันค่ะงานแต่งงานตามธรรมเนียมในประเทศไทยเจ้าบ่าวจะต้องให้บางอย่างแก่ครอบครัวเจ้าสาวสิ่งนั้นคืออะไรสินสอดเป็นสิ่งของที่ฝ่ายชายมอบให้พ่อแม่ฝ่ายหญิงถือเป็นค่าที่ท่านได้เลี้ยงดูฝ่ายหญิงมาจนโตส่วนมากจะให้เป็นเงินหรือบางครั้งฝ่ายชายก็อาจจะให้เป็นสิ่งของแทนเช่นที่ดินทองเป็นต้นส่วนใหญ่ก็จะให้ตามความเหมาะสมกับฐานะของฝ่ายชายบางครั้งพ่อแม่ฝ่ายหญิงก็ไม่รับเพื่อให้คู่บ่าวสาวเก็บเอาไว้เป็นทุนในการสร้างครอบครัวต่อไปบทเรียนนี้เป็นอย่างไรบ้างคะในประเทศของเพื่อนๆมีการเฉลิมฉลองวันวาเลนไทน์อย่างไรบ้างคะสุดท้ายนี้ถ้ามีความคิดเห็นอย่างไรก็ส่งมาให้พวกเราได้ที่ thaipod101.com แล้วพบกันได้ใหม่ในครั้งต่อไปคะ
Hi everyone, do you know how to say I love you in Thai?In this lesson, you'll learn three different ways to say it. Let's start with how to express your feelings to your loved one.
ฉันรักคุณ ฉันรักคุณ ฉันรักคุณ
Or if you want to explain those butterflies in your stomach, you can say
ฉันหลงรักเธออยู่ ฉันหลงรักเธออยู่ฉันหลงรักเธออยู
่ And when you feel that I love you is not enough, you can say
รักที่ฉันมีให้เธอไม่สามารถอธิบายได้ด้วยคำพูดรักที่ฉันมีให้เธอไม่สามารถอธิบายได้ด้วยคำพูดรักที่ฉันมีให้เธอไม่สามารถอธิบายได้ด้วยคำพูด
You just learned three different ways to say, I love you in Thai. Want to speak real Thai from your first lesson? Sign up for your free lifetime account at ThaiPod101.com.
Does having a study partner help you learn a language faster? For most people, having a friend or romantic partner who is a native speaker of their target language dramatically improves their ability to master the language. In this video, we'll talk about some ways to help you build relationships with people.We'll also talk about three reasons having a native speaker partner can improve your language fluency. First, knowing a native speaker helps you better understand the culture. Knowing a native speaker gets you connected with the culture in ways that no lessons or textbooks ever could. Native speakers are better informed about the latest slang expressions and know interesting places to eat and hang out. Having a friend or partner who is a native speaker can dramatically improve your understanding of the language.In addition to language, you can learn about cultural practices, gestures, and relationships. Second, having a native speaker partner increases your exposure to the language. Practice makes perfect is a well-known expression that is certainly true for language learning. When you have a friend, romantic partner, or study buddy, you speak to them through text messages, phone calls, and basic interaction. These are all opportunities for you to practice the language.Making an effort to practice will help your vocabulary quickly expand beyond simple greetings, flirtatious words, and basic comments to deeper, more meaningful conversations. Third, Third, a supportive partner is the best study aid you can find. We all make mistakes, especially when trying to learn a new language. But if you have a supportive partner, they can gently point out your mistakes and help you find better ways to express yourself. And if your native speaker study partner is also your romantic partner, your motivation will likely be even higher than someone who does not have a romantic relationship with a native speaker. Now, let's look at three ways our language learning program helps you learn even faster if you have a native speaker partner. First, all resources and materials are available in English and in your target language. Studying with a partner is special because it's an opportunity for both of you to learn a new language. That's why every single lesson, transcript, vocabulary list, and resource on our website is available in English and in your target language. You can learn from each other. Second, lessons are designed to help you understand and engage with culture. On our website, our focus is to help our students learn practical vocabulary and phrases that are actually used in everyday conversation. This means that from your very first lesson, you can start applying what you learn immediately. So if you want to go out to a restaurant, play games, or attend a social function with your partner, you'll have the vocabulary and phrases necessary to have a great time. Third, access to special resources dedicated to romantic phrases. If your study partner is your romantic partner, we have resources to help you communicate your feelings correctly. Our language learning program has special sections and tools to teach you love words, phrases, and cultural insights. Of course, please remember that simply being in a relationship is no substitute for studying. Communication is key to every relationship, whether romantic or not. If you fail to continue expanding your vocabulary and you stop learning the language on your own, your relationships may suffer or fizzle out. Without question, spending time with native speakers can help you dramatically improve your language proficiency. But this is no replacement for focused studying. It's essential to help facilitate better communication and master the language. So, if you're ready to finally learn a new language the fast, fun, and easy way, sign up for your free lifetime account by clicking on the link in the description. Signing up takes less than 30 seconds, and you'll start speaking from your very first lesson. If you enjoyed these tips, hit the like button, share the video with anyone who's trying to learn a new language, and subscribe to our channel. We release new videos every week. I'll see you next time. Bye! Being able to speak freely with native speakers is an amazing ability in itself. But being able to speak freely to a whole new group of people opens you up to possible new relationships. Most people don't realize that spending the time to build relationships in a foreign language can actually help you improve your language skills dramatically. In this video, we look at how making relationships in a foreign language can help you learn the language faster. The benefits of having friends and partners who speak a foreign language. First, it's motivational. One of the greatest struggles for anyone learning a second language is motivation. 9 times out of 10, learners start out their language learning journey with loads of enthusiasm, only to see it gradually wane over time. Try as they may, it's difficult to maintain the spark they once shared with their new language. So why not borrow energy from a different part of your life? When you make relationships with people in your target language, all the excitement of a new relationship carries directly over into your learning. Suddenly, you have a very rewarding reason to improve your skills and keep practicing. As your partner or your friends get involved, you will also have the advantage of a constant source of support and encouragement. Second, it makes language learning practical. Studying vocabulary and grammar is a vital part of language learning, whether you use a podcast, textbook, app, or find yourself in a classroom. However, as great as studying is, a language really only starts to come alive once you start using it in everyday life. There's a huge difference between a scripted conversation in a lesson plan and a real-life conversation with a native speaker. Building relationships with native speakers will give you the chance to talk in your target language often. Furthermore, it will be in a way that feels natural. You'll learn the words in the context, which is hugely important. Third, it's fun. One of the greatest benefits is that it allows you to practice without having it feel like practice. Oftentimes, you'll find yourself so wrapped up in the conversation that you forget you're using a foreign language. This takes a lot of the pressure off and helps you focus on communication over trying to speak absolutely perfectly. You also get to learn about a whole new culture from your partner or friends, so you're not only learning language skills, but also about the cultures that surround your target language. The risks of having friends and partners who speak a foreign language. First, it's easy to miscommunicate.
When it comes to relationships, humans can easily misunderstand each other. So it can be hard when building relationships in your target language when you or your partner's lack of ability in each other's respective native tongue can lead to miscommunications that would otherwise be avoidable. Depending on the language you're speaking, a simple mistranslation or mispronounced word can drastically change the meaning of a sentence. As long as you can afford each other some extra patience and the benefit of the doubt, then you should be able to overcome this pitfall. Second, your language skills could suffer if your relationships don't work out. If all your language practice is wrapped up in one person and your relationship with that person doesn't work out, then your language learning could take a big hit. So it's best not to put all your hopes for language growth on one area, relationship or otherwise. You don't want to risk losing motivation, so try to find it in many different areas. An idea for building relationships in a foreign language. Make games out of getting to know one another. Sometimes, opening up in any new friendship or partnership can be hard. Add in the added struggle of a new language, and it can feel impossible to share your true feelings with others. So instead of trying to take first interactions so seriously and talking about the usual things like the weather or work, try to ask new, interesting questions. Try to figure out what the other person's hobbies are without asking directly, or what kind of job they have. This will give you a chance to stretch your language skills in a new way, and you'll probably get some funny answers out of it too. Being comfortable being silly or making language mistakes is a great way to bond with someone, even if you've just met. Relationships in a foreign language have a lot more benefits to offer than drawbacks. Don't be scared to open up to people and make mistakes. And for even more help to build relationships in your target language, check out our complete language learning program. Sign up for your free lifetime account by clicking on the link in the description. Get tons of resources to have you speaking in your target language. And if you enjoyed these tips, hit the like button, share the video with anyone who's trying to learn a new language, and subscribe to our channel. We release new videos every week. I'll see you next time. Bye.
Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Thai Top Words. I'm Jay, and today we'll be doing something very interesting. So our lesson today is 5 amazing love quotes from Thai songs. Let's get started. ตั้งแต่พบกันวันนั้นใจก็รู้ว่าเราจะมีกันวันนี้เธอเติมเต็มสิ่งดีๆให้ทุกวันที่มีกลายเป็นวันที่มีความหมาย Ever since we met that day, my heart knew we would be together up to this day.You fill me up with good things, so that every day is a day of purpose and meaning. That's a bit deep. So the song would go like, ding 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 ding, ding 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 ding. ตั้งแต่พบกันวันนั้นใจก็รู้ว่าเราจะมีกันวันนี้เธอเติมเต็มสิ่งดีๆให้ทุกวันที่มีกลายเป็นวันที่มีความหมาย I'm not a good singer but yeah it's a very good song I personally like this song myself so it's on YouTube so you can find it and listen to it so this song is sang by this amazing singer called Da Endorphin the name of the song is The More I Get to Know YouThe more I love you but in Thai it is ยิ่งรู้จักยิ่งรักเธอก็เพราะว่าเธอคือของขวัญที่สวรรค์ให้มาฉันจะเก็บรักษามันเอาไว้ให้นานจะไม่ให้ใครมาทำร้ายเธอถ้าฉันยังยืนอยู่ตรงนี้ Because you are the present from heaven I will never let it go Nobody can hurt you if I stand here This song is called เธอคือของขวัญ or You are a presentSang by สิงโตนำโชค Try to look it up. It's a very nice song. คือเรื่องมหัศจรรย์ที่เราได้พบกันคือเรื่องมหัศจรรย์ที่ฉันได้รักเธอคือเรื่องมหัศจรรย์ที่สุดที่ฉันเคยได้เจอเธอคือเรื่องมหัศจรรย์ It's a miraculous event that we met. It's a miraculous event that I could love you. It's the biggest miraculous eventI could have met. You are a miraculous event. So this song is sang like this. คือเรื่องมหัศจรรย์ที่เราได้พบกันคือเรื่องมหัศจรรย์ที่ฉันได้รักเธอคือเรื่องมหัศจรรย์ที่สุดที่ฉันเคยได้เจอเธอคือเรื่องมหัศจรรย์ If you notice this quote has a lot of มหัศจรรย์ like this word มหัศจรรย์ means miracle or miraculous it's not a word that you willcome across quite often, but I think it's a very nice word. This song is called Miraculous Event or เรื่องมหัศจรรย์ which is sung by this band called SOFA. Actually, this song is quite old. I have listened to it and have known it for many years. I think since I was very young, so I think most Thai people know about this song. ฉันอยากจะหยุดเวลานี้ตั้งแต่วินาทีที่มีเธอเข้ามาเธอทำให้คนที่ใจเหนื่อยล้านั้นกล้าที่จะเปิดหัวใจ I want to stop this time from the second you came into my life. You made this person who was exhausted able to open up his heart. This song is called หยุด or Stop in Thai by Groove Riders. Actually, this band is super cool. You should check them out.แค่เพราะหัวใจมันบอกอาจไม่ค่อยพอแต่ฉันก็ยังมั่นใจว่าต้องใช่เธอเสียงหัวใจเรียกร้องแปลกๆให้รู้สึกดีที่มีเธอ It's just because my heart told me it might not really be enough but I'm still certain that you must be the one The voice of my heart crying out strangely making me feel good to have youแค่เพราะหัวใจมันบอกอาจไม่ค่อยพอแต่ฉันก็ยังมั่นใจว่าต้องใช่เธอเสียงหัวใจเรียกร้องแปลกๆให้รู้สึกดีที่มีเธอ I really love this song it's like it's an old song but the meaning is very good like you can see it from the English translation it's really good it has a great meaning it is sang by This great singer called Anne Titima. She's not young anymore, but for us, like, she's one of the greatest singer in Thailand. Oh, and the name of the song is Siang Khong Hua Jai, The Voice of My Heart. Okay, we are done for today's lesson. Thank you for watching. So have you known any of these songs before? Or do you have any recommendation for the songs that you like? If you do, please let us know in the comment below. And don't forget to click like to this video, subscribe to our channel, and go to thaipod101.com. See you next time. Bye-bye.
Great work. Here's a reward. Speed up your language learning with our PDF lessons. Get all of our best PDF cheat sheets and ebooks for free. Just click the link in the description.